From runway to railway, the Oscars may be about the best in film, but they're also about the best dressed. Joining me this morning to talk about the best and the worst dressed of the night is our fashion panel. Personal stylist Jill Marinelli, local mom blogger Audrey McClellan, and founder of Style Week Providence, Rosanna Ortiz-Sanel. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning.
Lots of looks to go through, so we're just going to jump right into it. You know, you guys told us some of your best and your worst, so we're going to start with Michelle Williams in Louis Vuitton. Tell us about this look. What did you guys like about it?
Well, I'm guessing we all picked her. Did we all pick her?
I didn't pick her. I loved it, but she wasn't on my top three.
No,
really? She wasn't?
Yeah,
so this was all me.
Threw me off.
All right, Jill. So this is your pick.
I'm totally obsessed with this color. It's kind of like that tangerine tango, orange, reddish. I just thought it looked beautiful. And in the past, I haven't actually liked what she's worn on the red carpet. She's really covered up and, to me, looked frumpy. But this was just fresh and beautiful, and I thought she looked fantastic.
The color is
I love the color.
And everyone's talking about
it.
Another look that everyone was talking about was Gwyneth Paltrow in Tom Ford. Now, a couple of you liked her.
Favorites.
What? Okay. Yeah, Rosanna, you're saying one of your favorites.
I was really obsessed with all the white on the run on the red carpet. I keep saying runway, so I'm clearly not out of style.
You're in the styling mode.
But on the red carpet, the white just popped, and it's so. It's sculptural. It's perfect. It's just
stunning.
Linear. You know, the lack of accessories. She looks perfect.
Yeah,
and it's a little bit of a risk. You know, it's a little bit of a risk, the cape, so I think she did well.
Yeah, the cape.
She pulled that off so well.
A few minutes before she was on the red carpet, she tweeted a picture of herself, like, from her car.
Oh, she did?
And I saw, it must have been taken by her husband or assistant or something, and she just looked fabulous. She couldn't see the whole dress, but I was like, ooh, and then I just was ready to see
her. I liked it.
I thought she looked regal.
But then when she was on the stage with Robert Downey Jr., I loved it.
Without the cape.
Yes,
I enjoyed that as well.
The neckline is stunning.
It is. It's gorgeous.
I love that asymmetry.
All right, so from white to more of a bold color, Emma Stone. Jill, why did this look work for you?
I loved it because I think this is a difficult thing to wear.
Mm-hmm.
A top that comes all the way up with a huge bow at the neck.
It's a big bow.
I could not pull that off myself, so maybe I was just jealous. I thought the color was fabulous, and she kind of just said, screw it, I have red hair and I'm wearing red, and she totally rocked it.
Yeah, maybe too because she is so tall and thin that having that big bow really offset that. Okay, let's move on to Cameron Diaz.
She was my favorite.
Okay.
That's who I had on my top list.
I didn't love her hair. I was stuck on her hair.
It's funny because usually I gravitate towards moms on the runway because I think too a problem. I don't know if you guys like this. I always go for what I would wear, and I would wear this. You know, I really loved it. I love the flow. I love the cut.
I could see you in that. I think you look better in that though.
Do you think so? I would try to rock it better than Cameron. I would, but I just thought she dazzled. And I had seen her get interviewed by Tim Gunn, and she really brought you from head to toe through her outfit. And I just thought it looked very glam and glitz. The Oscars.
Yeah.
All right, now a woman that you guys had some difficulty last dress that we were looking at, you actually loved this one. We're talking about Angelina Jolie, and why did you like this dress on her?
Was I the only one that liked this one?
I'm in the middle. I think you loved and you hated, so go.
So you're saying appropriately. Love, hate, and
I'm like teen Angelina, okay? I have been. I love Brad Pitt. I love this because mostly I was remembering what she wore at the Golden Globes, and I really didn't like it. You know, and I know that a lot of people had, like, they either loved it or they hated it, and I hated it. I just thought she's very skinny, and I thought it just was too much for her to wear on the runway. And so when I saw her in this one, I thought, okay, finally she nailed a red carpet event in 2012, the beginning, because I really didn't like how she looked before, but I loved this.
You know, and I can understand that. I mean, the dress itself is actually, it's stunning. The dress is beautiful. I think it was how it was styled that I didn't like.
Yeah.
Her hair maybe was a little too disheveled. I think they both looked a little disheveled. Jonathan Peters said, she looked like Captain Morgan with her knee hanging out.
All right. So you're talking about disheveled people. Let's get into some of the worst. Rooney Mara first up. Audrey, you're not a fan of this one.
Did you like this one?
I cannot say no to Givenchy.
Well, I know. She's gorgeous. Like, I just felt she's, and maybe it's a whole Angelina thing. I feel she's very skinny, and I just feel like, and maybe I'm just thinking as a mom here, I felt like this, I would not want my daughter to see this and go, okay, I got to be this skinny, and I just think it showed off the skin and bones. So really, that was just where I was coming from.
All right, now one that looked a little bigger was Sandra Bullock, and this didn't really work for her. Jill, why not?
I didn't like it. I mean, I love Marquesa, but this to me just didn't work. I didn't like all the embellishment around, like, the waist and hips. It didn't give her any kind of a shape.
The back was pretty.
Yeah, the back was pretty.
But otherwise, I just didn't think it flattered, and I thought that her face was looking a little too worked on.
Oh, interesting. She has such a beautiful figure, too. I mean, her figure is knockout.
Yeah, and so
how the embroidery make her look wide.
Mm-hmm. And she's not. That's too bad.
And I love Marquesa.
Just not for Sandra Bullock. All right, ladies, thank you so much for joining us and giving us your input. And for a photo gallery of more fashion hits and misses from the night, you can head to WPRI.com.